On November 8th of 2023, many Texas residents were awakened to a hazard that the state is largely unfamiliar with. I am not referring to a weather-related phenomena such as hurricanes, hail, or tornadoes, but rather a geologic hazard, earthquakes. As at 4:27 a.m. local time on November 8th, a moderate magnitude 5.2 earthquake struck the state, causing the ground to shake for approximately 30 seconds. This shaking appears to have reached a maximum acceleration equivalent to 12% the force of gravity, which, if there were more abundant structures at the epicenter, might have caused items to fall off of the shelves. Shaking was felt over an area approximately the size of the state of Kentucky, reportedly even being felt slightly in Las Cruces. This 5.2 quake was unusually large for Texas, representing only the state's 6th magnitude 5 range quake. However, earthquakes including of this magnitude have seemingly been increasing each year, with 4 of these 6 quakes occurring since 2020. And this year, Texas has been struck by a total of 604 magnitude 2.5 or larger earthquakes, which is only a little less than the 678 such quakes that struck California in the same time period. This might not initially make sense, as on the countrywide color-coded earthquake hazard map the United States Geological Survey has, the most hazardous area in Texas only is colored yellow, while the majority of California is colored maroon, red, orange, and yellow. So, why is Texas all of a sudden producing so many earthquakes? The answer, in my opinion, likely, although not certainly, relates to the oil industry. And I do not say this as a political statement, as a somewhat similar phenomenon sometimes occurs as certain geothermal power plants also largely occurring due to wastewater injection. At some geothermal power plants, wastewater is injected into the ground so it flashes to steam before rising again to generate electricity. This can generate earthquakes in two ways. The first way is since the water is either pumped into an area which previously did not have as much water, or is drained beyond what used to exist there, this process can cause stress change at regional fault lines. As a result, pressure builds up over time before finally being released as an earthquake. The second way is that wastewater injected back into the ground seeps into a nearby fault and lubricates it, allowing it to more easily slip and triggering an earthquake. In the case of the oil and natural gas industry, induced earthquakes can occur via both fracking and wastewater injection. It has been proven for some time that both can induce earthquakes, and this is why Oklahoma recently experienced an all-time high rate of earthquakes, including a magnitude 5.6 event. However, not all fracking operations generate earthquakes larger than magnitude 1, and the vast majority of wastewater injection wells related to the oil and gas industry do not appear to cause any induced earthquakes. But some in each category do appear to generate induced earthquakes. In oil fields, generally speaking, about 48 out of 49 induced quakes are caused by wastewater injection, with the remaining 1 of 49 being caused by fracking. In oil deposits, oil generally exists in a permeable rock layer containing several gallons of salt water for every gallon of oil. Fracking is sometimes used, if profit margins and laws allow it to be used, in part to purposely generate earthquakes with magnitudes less than 1 to increase permeability in the oil-bearing layer, allowing the resource to be more easily extracted. This often is done through injecting fluids, which, if performed in close proximity to a fault line, can increase the pressure on it, causing it to eventually slip and generate an earthquake. Yet, while fracking does occur in the associated oil field where the recent magnitude 5.2 quake occurred, I do not believe that was the cause. As instead, I believe that waste salt water obtained during oil extraction, which was subsequently pumped back into the ground, was the cause. This wastewater was injected around 4.8 kilometers or around 15,700 feet deep into the crust below the oil-bearing layer, where it spread out in a porous rock layer. However, as this occurs, the wastewater can sometimes directly interact with any fault lines the water encounters, lubricating the fault and generating an earthquake. Thus, while it is fully possible that the 5.2 earthquake could have been natural, as hey, Texas had a seemingly natural 5.8 in 1931 and a 5.7 in 1995, the odds are statistically likely that the quake on November 8th was caused by wastewater injection. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.